it's a tale of like multiple seasons for us. You know, game one, we're playing North Carolina and we go up 1-0. We're 1-0 up at halftime, you know, against the number two team of the country at that time. And then the second game to get a well-earned draw at Wake Forest, who's in the NCAA tournament this year. You know, those were positive starts. But what you end up seeing intermixed in the season were hiccups and blips that were a result of scenarios that have kids that are immature in a positive way, trying to figure it out. And then you saw some moments where they would group together and run off a string of decent performances, and you know, for us to, you know, finish fourth in the pack is an improvement from last year. So we're looking at all those improvement pieces going forward into this offseason. When you look at the end of the season record, it does leave a salty taste in all of our mouths, because that's what ends up getting you in the tournament and getting you where you want to go. But I think when you're looking at the body of work and what we're trying to do here and the growth that we're trying to promote, there was a lot, because you had a lot of people cut teeth again that got a lot of minutes. And we had to go through some adversity, like every team to some degree does. But, you know, for us, go through the adversity of growing and injuries and giving players opportunities. It ended up being a season that I think we can really put our front foot forward and be excited about the off season and how we're going to develop these young kids. I think everybody's pretty excited about taking that next step, you know. And any time you get a challenge thrown out there by other situations, you know, you want to step up and see if you can exceed that. And in that regard, you know, we did in our conference, in a very difficult conference. But at the same time, I think we have the bar a little bit higher for ourselves. And so when you raise the bar high on yourselves and you don't quite get there, you always are disappointed. And that's what it means to be competitive. But, you know, when you look at the bigger picture, you usually don't hit that in one shot. You know, there's many ways to get to the top of the mountain. And for us, it's going to go through it and do it the right way. You know, we're going to develop these kids. We're going to continue to bring in the right players. And their growth and through these experiences, and I've been through this several other times with different programs, learning hurts sometimes. But I do know that there's a payoff if you're honest and you do it right. And I think that all of our guys are excited. They really are. All of our guys are excited about the off season. We're excited about next fall and excited to continue to make steps to where we want to go. Kyrie missing a good chunk of the season did impact us. You know, it really did. And the poor kid plays a great game at Wake Forest. Don't quite know if he's injured or hurt, or if it's something that is a normal battle scar that you would get. And the next game he's hobbling around, so we sit him out for about 3 weeks, and then he comes back against Washington in our first Pac-12 game and dominates Washington. And then after that, he can't put weight on it. And so it was a kind of an interesting scenario with Kyrie. And boy, did we all go through the ups and downs of emotions trying to figure out what it was. But at the end of the day, ended up being a broken navicular on his foot there. And so now he's got a nice big old screw that's in there, and he's healing nicely. His spirits are good. It's hard to keep your spirits up when you want to help your team. Those four guys that you mentioned, I think, are well deserved of their awards, and I know that to each player, they would trade that award to be in the NCAA tournament. But having said that, when I talk to each one, I think they will tell you there's more that they can give, and there's more improvement they can have. And so that's kind of the mantra that we have right now, that, you know, there's some things we did well, but we need to do more. And that's to an individual player. And that's why, you know, if you're a coach and you like to teach players, you know, this type of off season here at Oregon State with our men's soccer program is going to be fantastic, because you have a bunch of kids who now have some experience. Sometimes, you can have the talent, but when you don't have that experience of going through a season, you know, you can't coach experience. You know, you can coach tactics, you can coach this and that, but when you have that experience, it's the X factor of what you do in the off season. So now the guys know what it's like to take UCLA into double overtime and feeling that they could have got something more out of it. You only know that if you've been through it. And you know, for us, it's going to be something we're all going to look forward to. The nice thing about this offseason is going to be very competitive. You know, when you get 20, 23 guys that are going to be on your roster in the offseason, that's a pretty large roster. And that's exactly what I want for this group going into 12, because I want it to be competitive. I want guys to be at their best every single session. So something that we're going to really have fun with.